Namaste crafters, Devika here today on Mudra Craft Stamps blog with a tutorial on how to make jewellery with Mudra Craft Stamps and stencils. I've already applied a coat of gesso and white acrylic paint on the Chand Bali bases. Now take the pretty stencil by Mudra Craft Stamps and apply aqua dazzle paste through it. If you don't have the paste, you can simply apply normal acrylic, chalk or any other paint of your choice. Spread it evenly across the whole surface till you are satisfied with it. Remove the stencil and any excess paste from the edges. Do the same with the other piece also. Out of all the projects for today, this is my personal favorite one. It's just so simple and elegant and so pretty. Similarly, I painted the base of the other pair with the sea green chalk paint and then applied the pumpkin paste through it. I love the rustic look on this piece. Now comes the magical glow-in-the-dark earrings. So when you do wear it at night or put it in a dark room, it does glow in the dark. For this piece, I painted it with black chalk paint and applied the fog dazzle paste with the glow-in-the-dark paint. To be frank, it was just a trial for me, but successfully it did work. When it's mixed properly, apply the mixture through the star stencil by Mudra Craft Stamps on both the pieces and let it dry. Like I've used the stencils, now I will use the stamps. Take the old script saying stamp set. Cover it with black archival ink and stamp it on the Chand Bali base. As the Chand Bali is a bit curved at the edges, you obviously won't get the complete stamp impression on the edges. But don't worry, I'll show you later how to cover it. In order to cover the unstamped area, just stamp enough ink on the edges of the stamp set, covering 1 to 2 lines maximum, depending on how much area you want to stamp on again. Carefully align it to the unstamped area and press it gently at the edges, and the surface is covered. And still, if you have any surface left unstamped, simply take a black non-bleeding marker and cover it with it. Similarly, I have used the mandala mini stamp set and stamped it on the red base following the same technique like I did above. In this project, I did purposely leave out the outside part a bit unstamped to give it a very relict, ancient, rustic and a terracotta sort of a look. And if you thought this is it, it's not it. You can also use the Chipzeb by Mudra Craft Stamps to make the jewelry. For example, in this project, I am using the honeycomb Chipzeb on a purple colored base. Cut out a tentative portion and paint it with a deep yellow chalk paint and let it dry. Fix it on the base with a strong glue and when it's dry, cut out the excess portion with a sharp scissors. Once all the bases were dry, I added laces around the edges and adhered the earring studs at the back of each earring piece with a very strong adhesive, and the pretty jewelry sets are ready to be worn. I also covered them with a coat of resin to make them waterproof. This is, however, optional. You can simply varnish them instead of putting the resin. just how easy it is to create a jewelry collection of your own with this stencil, stamp and chipzeb collection by Mudra Craft Stamps. I hope you all enjoyed today's projects. Do let us know in the comments below which one is your favorite. Thank you.